This may well be the future of electronics. It's a charger that's a little bit smaller than other chargers.
Okay, this isn't the future, but the fact that it's a little bit smaller may be a sign of things to come. And it's all thanks to a special material hidden inside. So let's get in there.
I don't know if this is gonna help us.
I say we use the hammer.
No, it cracked. Okay, we're getting somewhere. Boom. Boom. Look at that.
The material we're after is called gallium nitride, or GaN. It's a super effective semiconductor. Some materials like copper are very good at conducting electricity, while materials like glass are not. Semiconductors are about halfway between those two extremes, which makes them really versatile for different products. That means GaN stands to replace the material that currently rules the electronics industry, silicon. Gallium nitride could pave the way for a whole new generation of miniaturized tech, and it could make that charger even smaller.
So it will get to the point where you just have a cable going straight from the outlet in your laptop, and this, you need basically this gallium nitride electronics to make that happen.
That's Martin Kubal. He's a professor at the University of Bristol in the United Kingdom. He's an expert in gallium nitride, and he has bigger dreams of the material than chargers. Better solar cells, more efficient power transmission. There's a lot up for grabs.
Electric cars which only use gallium nitride. And that makes it much more efficient than current cars, so they would have a longer range to drive.
What we're tearing apart right now is a charger from Anker called the PowerPort Atom PD1. It's one of the early mass-produced gadgets to use GaN semiconductors. It's not super visible, but hidden inside this chip is gallium nitride. It's responsible for managing the power use and energy consumption of the device. Now, you might be familiar with the element gallium. YouTube loves it, there are a million videos dedicated to playing with it, and it is a lot of fun. Its melting point is around 86 degrees Fahrenheit, which means just your body heat alone is enough to turn it into a liquid. But as the silicon of the future, gallium isn't really that exciting until you combine it with nitrogen.
I mean, you use some gases which contain gallium, you have some gases which contain nitrogen, and you basically flow them across a hot surface, and these gases react chemically, and then you form very tiny, thin layers of this material. They're maybe 1/100th of a human hair thickness, so they're very, very small, but very, very powerful.
Martin says he's been following gallium nitride tech for 15 or 20 years, and in that time, it's popped up in a few common places. The major market is in LEDs and lasers. Blu-ray DVD players actually use GaN lasers to read discs and get that super high resolution. And some labs are using tiny GaN lasers to improve microscopes.
But semiconductors are where gallium nitride will really take off. The key is that GaN edges out silicon when it comes to efficiency.
You lose maybe only 1% of the energy you're basically trying to convert, whereas if you take a silicon device, you use 3%.
That doesn't sound like a lot, but when you consider just how much silicon we use in everything, it adds up.
If you look at gallium nitride electronics, it's slightly more expensive than silicon. Not dramatically more expensive. But if you build the whole system, using gallium nitride is actually much, much cheaper than using silicon and better performance.
There's the sustainability angle too. Losing less energy means saving power. One estimate we found says that if we replaced all of our silicon electronics with GaN today, we'd save 10% of our electricity consumption in the US.
And that's really exciting, but remember, the immediate future of gallium nitride looks more like this little charger that I just destroyed. It's not gallium's fault. We know it works and it works really well, but the problem is systemic. Silicon is cheap, it's ubiquitous, we're used to it, and the entire electronics industry is built on it. Gallium nitride has researchers like Martin sold. It just has to do the same thing for Silicon Valley.
The main obstacle for widespread adoption is basically people just need to get used to it. It's a different component. You wouldn't take your normal circuit you put in there, you have a silicon component in there. You would normally not just take a gallium nitride component in there and replace that silicon component. So you have to replace or optimize the whole electronics around. So people tend to be conservative. They know it works, and they have to start rebuilding the circuits a little bit to make full advantage of this. That's happening right now, but that takes some time.
Right now, creating gallium nitride is expensive. You often have to use a lot of pressure or get very high temperatures to grow GaN crystals. And the growing process can lead to a lot of defects, which means you need even more to get enough of the useful stuff.
Some people are trying to grow gallium nitride on top of silicon, so we can use the platforms we already have. But even that still takes some special apparatuses. So for now, the industry will have to juggle multiple kinds of semiconductors.
Gallium nitride in some applications will be better than silicon. In some other applications, silicon will be better. There's another material called silicon carbide, has also benefits and drawbacks, or gallium oxide, vice versa. So it's a whole space you have to explore.
It'll be a little while before gallium nitride takes over the world, but the market does seem to be growing. Anker announced three new chargers with different specs that will all feature gallium nitride, and the company says there are more on the way. Meanwhile, Rav Power has also made a gallium nitride charger. So be patient. In the meantime, I'm gonna try to fix this one.
Hey everyone, thanks so much for watching.
If you wanna check out another video on materials, be sure to check out our ferrofluid video. I think you'll enjoy that a lot.
Oh no. No.
Check out another material.